Flares to full!
Shield up!
Fire everything!
There's a crack in the shield! What do we do?
Hey there, sunny dispositions. Trace and Julian here for DNews. The sun and the earth are in a constant battle thanks to the sun's tendency to be an unfathomably large mass of incandescent gas.
Yes, absolutely. It's a gigantic nuclear furnace where hydrogen is built into helium
at temperatures of millions of degrees.
But as a result, the sun is constantly releasing highly energized particles blasted away from these nuclear reactions. Mostly these particles are protons and electrons with some alpha particles, the nuclei of helium, and heavier charged particles thrown in like the nuclei of magnesium, sulfur, iron, neon, carbon, and titanium, among others.
Sometimes the sun gets excited and it releases a mass of superheated charged plasma called a coronal mass ejection, or CME. We've talked about them before, they're crazy.
And that's when the Earth's magnetosphere is really challenged. These CMEs can be strong enough to damage satellites, force airplanes to change course to avoid them, disrupt electronics on the ground, and force astronauts to stay in the shelter of the International Space Station.
The main thing stopping these pungently radioactive, highly charged particles from hitting you and me on top of the head is the Earth's trusty magnetic field. Generated by the movement of iron through our mantle, the magnetosphere works like a shield, protecting us from harmful CMEs and other charged particles, but our shield system has a crack in it.
Oh no!
That's right, new research from the GRAPES 3 muon telescope reads like a battle report from Star Trek.
Trace's log, stardate June 22nd, 2015. A plasma ejection from the sun struck our planet at 2.5 million kilometers per hour.
The energetic collision caused, I can't do Shatner. The energetic collision caused a compression of the magnetosphere between 2 and 5.5 times the width of Earth itself, causing magnetic storms and radio blackouts all over the planet. We suspect the Romulans are involved.
We don't.
Yes, we do.
No, we don't. Trace out. Okay, let me explain. A muon telescope is a cosmic ray detector. It's designed to keep an eye on cosmic rays breaching the magnetosphere. It's looking for cracks, and it found one. The magnetosphere is powerful, but it's not perfect. According to the data published in Physical Review Letters, the GRAPES 3 spotted a 20 gigaelectron volt collision with the magnetosphere, and then some leakage. A crack in the field!
Reverse the polarization!
I'm so sorry. Anyway, for perspective, the Large Hadron Collider, the world's most powerful particle accelerator, can hit a top energy of about 26 GeV when accelerating only a few protons at a time. The solar assault lasted for 2 hours at 20 GeV, and coronal mass ejections are filled with plasma stretching half the distance from the Earth to the sun.
Luckily for us down here under the shield, it deflected the burst of solar plasma. But CMEs aren't the only thing attacking Earth at any given moment. There are also those pesky cosmic rays.
So to keep up the Star Trek references, the sun is like the Romulan fleet. But cosmic rays are more like a few shuttlecraft or escape pods. They're from other galaxies, black holes, and the like, and while they're few, they are also constantly trying to leak down to us.
And this is where that crack comes in. When the CME assaulted the magnetosphere at such high energy, our field deflected it, which is great. But while it did that, some of those low-energy cosmic rays leaked through. At that point, the energy was likely absorbed by molecules in our upper atmosphere before it hit you or me.
In fact, the muon detector doesn't directly detect cosmic rays or coronal mass ejections at all. Instead, it detects muons, subatomic particles that are created when cosmic rays hit the molecules of air in our atmosphere. So GRAPES 3 detected this burst of activity, the crack, that normalized after the CME ended. Shield integrity is nominal.
Thank you. Even though we're okay down here, astronauts on orbit, they're maybe less so. People in space are bombarded with cosmic rays. It's a real problem. Unlike some larger energetic particles of a CME, cosmic rays can penetrate the walls of the International Space Station and, of course, the astronauts inside. There's even a name for it when one flies through an astronaut's eyeball.
It's called cosmic ray visual phenomena.
Good band name.
It is good. And the ray basically causes the rods and cones to activate, creating a sparkle or spot. Astronaut Dom Pettit describes it like dancing fairies.
Good band name.
Not as much.
Of course, long-term exposure to cosmic rays, like on a trip to Mars, could cause permanent damage to brain cells. Not good.
Luckily for us, the mantle keeps turning under our feet, generating our magnetosphere shield, and keeping us safe from both CMEs and cosmic rays, and from brain damage.
Mostly.
Mostly.
Are you worried about radiation messing with your brain? Find out how exactly this invisible thing affects your DNA here.
So, what is your favorite Star Trek episode? Tell us in the comments, and please make sure to subscribe for more DNews.